In this video, I'm going to calculate the freezing point depression equation. Namely, derive the equation allows us to calculate what is the temperature decrease when we add a solute to a pure solvent. So pure solvent will freeze at a temperature TF, the freezing temperature. And when we add a solute, then the freezing temperature is decreased, and we'll refer to that as TD. Now the solid that forms does not contain the solute. It's the pure solvent now in solid form. We need a couple other terms to use in the derivation. So X1 is the mole fraction of the solvent. X2 is the mole fraction of the solute. These are only two components, so X2 is 1 minus X1. What we're interested in is at equilibrium at temperature TD. So I've written down the equilibrium equation. The solid is a pure phase, and so this is the fugacity of the pure solid, but at temperature TD, and this is the thing you have to keep in mind as you follow through this derivation. This is the mixture fugacity for component one in both cases, component one being our solvent. And so mole fraction we've defined. This is the activity coefficient for component one. And then this is the pure component fugacity liquid phase at temperature TD. So something we want to keep in mind is the fugacity of the liquid pure component does not equal the fugacity of the solid at the temperature TD. At the freezing point of the pure solvent, TF, these fugacities would be equal. So I'm going to take this equation relating fugacity to mole fraction. So I'm going to take this equation, I'm going to rewrite it in terms of the ratio of fugacities. And then I'm going to take the log of both sides of the equation. Well, the reason we're doing this is because the log of the fugacity ratio we can relate to Gibbs free energies. So this is now the Gibbs free energy of the solid. Component 1 at temperature D minus the Gibbs free energy of the liquid. Component 1, pure component, at temperature D divided by R times the temperature D. Well, I can write this as delta G component 1 at temperature D of fusion with a minus sign over RTD. So delta G of fusion is when we take the solid and we convert it to the liquid at the same temperature. And so this is minus delta G of fusion. So what we're going to do is calculate the delta G of fusion in terms of delta H and delta S. So I've written down from the definition of delta G in terms of T delta S, where these are the changes, fusion, component 1 at temperature D. So we can relate this to delta H and delta S of fusion at the freezing temperature of the pure solvent, TF, because these indeed are values that we know. So what I've drawn is a diagram where we can take advantage of the idea of state function. We're going from this point to this point, solid at temperature TD to liquid. This is delta H of fusion of the solvent, component 1. At temperature D. What we're going to do is say, first we will take this solid, raise its temperature to the freezing temperature, now convert it from solid to liquid, where delta H of fusion at the freezing temperature is a number that we know, and then we're going to lower the temperature of the liquid back to the final TD. We can imagine we do this. Doesn't mean physically we're doing this. We just can imagine, because now delta H of fusion at the temperature D is just the sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3. And so we can write the equation that describes that state function relationship. So what I've written is that delta H of fusion, namely what we're trying to calculate at temperature D, is equal to the term 1 plus 2, plus 3, where we assume constant heat capacities. It's a pretty good assumption for a liquid, particularly over a relatively narrow temperature range. Well, we can simplify this equation. So I've just rearranged it, and then I've defined delta Cp as this difference in the heat capacity of the liquid and the solid, just to make it easier to write the equations down. Now I'm going to do the same thing for entropy change, but I won't go through the detailed calculations the same way. I'll just write down the answer. So I use the same idea as state function. So I have, in this case, delta S for fusion of the solvent, component 1, at the temperature D is equal to delta S of fusion of the solvent at its freezing temperature for the pure component, and a delta Cp, a log term. And then I've substituted for delta S of fusion, delta H of fusion over Tf. And so this is a equation for all phase changes. Delta S is delta H over the temperature where the phase change takes place. So what I've done is just rewritten the equation from earlier, basically the definition of Gibbs free energy. And now I can substitute back this equation and this equation and just rearrange. And I'll just write down the final form of the equation after the rearrangement. I'm going to assume this term is small compared to the first two terms. And then we can, for these first two terms, factor out fusion. And if I want to have a common denominator, Tf, then becomes this, where I've ignored these other terms. So delta G of fusion of the solvent at the temperature D is related to delta H of fusion at the freezing point of the pure solvent, divided by that freezing point temperature, and then this temperature difference. So I've substituted in from the earlier equation, and then I used the relation between delta G and delta H and this temperature difference. And so now we can make some simplifications. The activity coefficient is approximately 1, which is a good approximation when x1 is close to 1. And then we also will assume that in the denominator that Td is approximately Tf. The freezing point depression is not a large number in general when we're using this equation. And so that's a reasonable assumption to make to simplify the equation. We'll make another simplification. So the log of x1 is the same as the log of 1 minus x2. But this is approximately equal to minus x2 when x2 is small. This is just a mathematical relationship. Now I can write down this difference in temperature. And then this equation says, since delta H of fusion, this is going from solid to liquid, so delta H of fusion is greater than 0. So the right side is positive, which means the left side is positive, which means freezing point of the pure component is greater than the freezing point of the mixture. So we have a freezing point depression. So this then is the equation that we can use in calculating the freezing point depression.